FS Elite at Flight Sim Expo 2024 is proudly brought to you by Pimax. Check out their Pimax Crystal Light right now for some of the best VR headsets available today. Next up, we have DOF Reality, and please welcome to the stage, Mark.
Hi guys, let's see if I can get some things out there. I didn't put any eyes out.
Need like a coaster camera.
I know, yeah, right? And we have, don't feel cheated, all that stuff's at our booth. If you want one, they're right there. So, Calton, you love flight, right? Just like the rest of us?
I do, yeah.
So, when you were a kid, did you ever like have the airplane and pretend you're flying?
All the time.
All that stuff? See how good that goes. Not bad.
Wow. We did the health and safety on that.
I forgot that page. Sorry about that. It didn't put in. Everybody's okay. Everybody signed the waiver, right?
We're good. Yeah, we're all good.
So when I was a kid, like when I was 8 years old, I went to Disneyland and I did Star Tours for the first time, and it blew me away. I was in this spaceship and we were flying through space, and it was amazing. I never, ever in my life thought I would actually have that experience in my home, where I didn't have to wait 4 hours in line or anything like that to do it. And so that's what we're going to talk a little bit about today. So I want to also thank you. Thank you and FS Elite for putting this on.
Of course.
I want to thank everybody for coming out to this event. I mean, we are just getting amazed by the people joining us and are interested in the product. So thank you all. And so thank you. I appreciate
it. Thank you. Enjoy.
Thank you. So this is going to be fairly short. I want to leave a little time for questions and answers at the end if you guys have anything. But what we're going to talk about today is motion simulators. And just like I mentioned a few minutes ago with that experience, what DOF Reality is it's a motion platform, but it's not like any other platform. It's purposely built for home use, ideally, and also affordability, because motion platforms have been around for a long time, but those ones at Disneyland, those are millions of dollars. A lot of the industrial ones, you're talking $10,000, $100,000, that kind of thing. So what we focus on DOF Reality is bringing the motion simulation to the masses. So let's talk a little bit about DOF Reality. So DOF Reality, we just hit in May our 10-year anniversary. So we've been around for 10 years doing flight sims. And it was co-founded by Igor, who is here. He actually started the company because he wanted to have motion himself. He saw the same problems, so he wanted to figure out how he could make motion affordable for everybody. And so he worked on developing one and making it to where the average person could actually get use of one of these. And since those 10 years, we've sold tens of thousands of units all over the world. So we've got a little bit of a good reputation there. We also, according to the numbers, have sold more motion platforms than all of our competitors combined. So our sales are more than all of our competitors. That's what the research is showing. So let's talk a little bit about what a motion platform is. So what a motion platform does is it takes telemetry or information from a game like a flight sim, and it translates it into physical motion in the rig. And so it moves you according to what you're seeing, in this case, in flight. Now, it can do it for racing. A lot of our history in the last 10 years has been in the racing genre, and so we're now transitioning. Some of the flight simmers have found that this experience is amazing in flight as well. So DOF is now adding to the flight. So we're kind of new to the flight sim market, so that's why we're out here and just sharing this experience with y'all. So basically, the movement of a motion platform, there are 6 degrees of motion in general. So you can do up to 6 motions. You can do your pitch, you know, this way. You can do your roll like on an ocean. And then you've got yaw, which is like your rudder movement. And then there's 3 additional ones. There's surge, which is forward and back. There's sway, which is side to side. And then there's heave, that are up and down. Now, we have units that do actually both. We have what's called the H3 and the H6, which obviously 3 is 3 degrees of motion. It's your pitch, your roll, and your yaw. And then we have the 6, which does the other 3. As I mentioned, a lot of the competitors, if you look at them, they can cost, you know, hundreds of thousands for the big ones. Even the ones that are more geared towards the average person, you're still talking $5,000 to $10,000 in a lot of cases. So the DOF Reality rigs are considerably less than most of those. So This is our most popular product. We're just talking about. This is the H3. This is what we're demoing over at booth 632. Come over, take a test flight for yourself, and you'll see it's got the 3 degrees of motion. So we did the pitch, the roll, and then the yaw. And so that's what it does. And that's really key for a flight, because when you're flying, you know, you take off, you get your pitch. When you're banking, you get your roll. And then the yaw when you're kicking your rudder around. So this unit here has 20 degrees motion. So that would be 10 degrees forward, 10 degrees back, 10 degrees to the left, 10 degrees to the right. And you can see all the other specs. One of the key things I want you guys to notice is the footprint of these things. So you always want to, if you're thinking about getting into motion, you want to always make sure you look at that footprint spec, because some of them can take 6 feet by 8 feet. You want to make sure you've got room in your house to fit one of these motion simulators in. The DOF Reality H3 is one of the smallest footprints you're going to find out there. In addition to that, it's quiet. So, you know, if you put it right next to the bed, your husband or wife might kick you out of the room if you use it then. But if you're downstairs or whatever, I have had no problems. So it's built to be quiet. It's built to be useful for the personal use in the home. So we talked about the 6 degrees of freedom. So this is the H6. And what you can see, we've added sway, surge, and heave. And so you'll see the animation here where that'll go through all of these. That heave right there is one of the key elements for flight simming. So for flight simming, the heave adds that feeling when you touch down on a runway or a carrier deck, maybe, you could feel that runway. You feel it when you hit it. And it's just, it's an amazing sensation. It just adds so much. You'll get a little bit of that from the H3 also. So, you know, that's kind of the thing. Now, what you do give up a little, you give a little of the motion range up because of the geometry, but it's still an amazing experience. I personally own one of these. This is the rig I use, and I would not get rid of it for the world. I absolutely love my rig. And so that is the H6. We also have a few other products that we're not showcasing here, but we see a lot of static rigs out here, a lot of people that just have their static cockpits with their HOTAS and stuff. We actually make a unit, it's called an M2 seat mover, that will actually go right under the seat, and it basically will move the seat. Everything else will stay static, but it'll move your seat. So if you already have an existing setup, but you want to try your hand at some of the motion, that M2 would be an ideal option for you. In addition to that, we also have a Pro line. If you're planning on using your simulator 8 hours a day, 7 days a week, we recommend you go to the Pro line. It's a little stronger motors. It can tolerate that. But the H line is fine. The Hero line is fine for home use. I've had mine for 3 years, and it still runs like a dream. So what we're going to talk about, the biggest advantages to the DOF Reality units, we talked about affordability. So we feel the DOF units are the best value in the market, bar none. We'll stack up against anyone. Dollar for dollar, we think we give you the best experience you can get if you're looking to get into motion. You can see they start at $1,435. So that $1,435 compared to that $100,000 price tag is considerably less. Now that's that seat mover that we were talking about. That's just that unit that goes under your rig, under your current cockpit, and moves your seat. But the prices don't go terribly high from that. So for example, the H3, because I know somebody's going to ask me, the H3 right now that we have demoed is $2,820. You compare that to that $100,000, it's quite a thing. So what I would recommend, come over and take a test flight and see if you think that's worth it. Also this weekend, the show special, 10% off that. If you decide to buy something this weekend, 10% off that price tag. And then if you're interested in the H6, come see me. I don't have the price on me now, but we can get that information for you as well. The durability of the units, as I said, the company's been in business for 10 years. I've personally had my unit for 10 years, or for the last 3 years, and it's fine. It's still in good shape. I check the bolts every 6 months to make sure everything's tight, but these things are built to last, so it will last you quite a while you enjoy your flight simming. So that's another more value-added piece to this. And then the other big thing is the upgradability. So one of the units that we have, here we have the H3. We actually have a version of it that doesn't have yaw, and it's a little more affordable. So it just does the pitch and roll. The nice thing about our units is if you started there and then down the road you decided, okay, I want a little bit more, or the funding allows for it, you can then buy an upgrade kit and go to the H3. And then if you're at the H3 and you decide, man, I really want to go to the H6, there's an upgrade kit for that as well. So you can upgrade as your budget or your desire allows. So that's another huge thing. So I'm talking about motion platforms and all this, but I want to just share with you some of the personal experience that I've had. Now, Believe it or not, I actually do not work for DOF. I'm just a sim enthusiast, but I fell in love with this company when I got my H6, and so they asked me to come out. And I was real hesitant when I first bought mine, because it's a lot of money. When I bought my H6, it was like, I think it was close to $6,000. You're like, boy, that's a lot of money if I don't like this. I can honestly tell you, standing here today, it was one of the best purchases I've ever made. I have gotten so much enjoyment out of my motion platform, I wouldn't get rid of it for the world. Now, what I'm gonna share with you now is a little embarrassing. I've got a video clip because we're talking about what they do. What you're gonna see next is me flying in DCS in my H6. And so I was in the F-14, and I actually had a human Rio, and so we've been searching for these MiGs all over. And so he was, you know, pulling up the radar and trying to find him. We finally found him, we're heading out there. So we're gonna engage some MiGs. And as soon as we hit the merge, I promptly threw the F-14 into a flat spin. Bad idea. So this is what the motion platform looks like when you don't fly well. So here we go.
I should get a diamond, right?
Fucking off on these guys, but they are.
No, he's close, right? I'm going after this guy. Yeah, that looks like 25.
Woo! Hold on. God.
Yeah. What the? We're back. See, I told you not to put any more motion in the platform. See what it does? Alright, let's come on, baby. Come on.
That's our altitude.
It's getting down there. We are. Oh yeah, it's time to punch out. Punch out.
Woo! Go for a swim.
This would be called feet wet.
So not my proudest moment by any means, but that will give you a sensation of what it feels like to be in an emotion sim. And again, I really encourage you all to come over and try a flight for yourself. One of the great experiences, we have 4 experiences to choose from over there, including some general aviation. We have a takeoff section where you'll actually feel what it feels like to taxi, get on the runway. You'll feel that runway noise as you're running down the runway, and then when you pull up and rotate, you'll feel all that go away. And that's one of my favorite experiences, short of getting shot off of a catapult in an F-18. That's my favorite by far. But that's basically what I have for you guys, and I'd love to do any questions and answers. We have a few minutes. So if you guys have any questions at all, I'd love to answer them. And again, please feel free to come and try our units and our products. And we have paper airplanes over there. We have all kinds of stuff over there for you guys to look at, and we hope you'll join us later. So let's see what kind of questions we got. Let's see if I can make up some answers.
So the only difference between the H6 and the Pro 6 is the robustness of the Pro 6?
In general, technically the motors are a little faster, but realistically, since DOF came out what's called a SFU gear drive, so DOF is always innovating, so we're constantly trying to improve the units and make them easier to assemble or more durable or whatever it is. So it's a constant innovative process. Once they came out with what was called the SFU gearboxes, it pretty much took away the advantage that the P had as far as the motion and everything. So you're really getting the same performance for the most part out of both. You only really need to go to a P series if you're looking at, you know, doing it for long term. What I reckon, because I get this question all the time, well, should I buy a P3, or an H6. For me, because the price is pretty close when you go pro, I would recommend the H6. For me personally, I love those extra degrees of freedom. And by the way, this unit, I know we're at a flight sim conference, but this unit can be used for other things. You can use it for racing as well. You're not locked into flight sim. The unit basically runs off of any software. So I even use it for Star Wars Squadrons or Elite Dangerous, if any of you guys like flight sims. Elite Dangerous is one of the most incredible experiences in virtual reality in one of those. So it's very versatile. You can use it for basically any title that is a simulator. So hopefully that answers your question. All right.
What is the difference in price between starting with the H2 or H3 and upgrading to the H6 versus just starting out with the H6? What's the difference in price?
At the end of the day, I don't have the exact numbers. At the end of the day, you're essentially going to end up paying about the same as you would if you just bought it outright. So the incremental upgrades, by the time you're done with it, you're going to basically end up probably where you would have been, give or take, any inflation or anything. The disadvantage if you do it that way is you obviously have shipping that, so you're paying extra shipping for everything. That's a disadvantage to going that route. But the fact you have that option, if it's going to be a few years, you know, it's really not incremental. It's not like this exorbitant amount. It pretty much goes up, and you'll end up paying about what you pay would have paid out of the box. So, and real quick, you tried it. What'd you think? Did you like it?
I'm either buying it today or I'm buying it.
So he's either buying it today or buying it this weekend. And he's not a plant. I'll get you your $5 later. But so please come over and try our experience. Our booth is right over there, booth 632. But you see it's the horde of people around it. So another question we have?
Yeah, just a quick question here. How much power is this thing using, just out of curiosity?
Technically, I don't have all the power specs. Igor, the CEO, would have those details. But generally, you can run it off of a household plug. So you don't need anything special. I special wired mine because I didn't want to have any problems. So I ran a 30-amp breaker straight from the breaker box to my plug to make sure that I didn't have any problems. But I hear from all the people all the time that there's no issues. They plug it in. Now, one thing I will tell you, if you do the H6, it has two control boxes. So each box has a plug. What you do want to be careful of is you don't want to plug those both into the same outlet or the same circuit in your house. It can blow a breaker if it's a problem, it'll just pop the breaker. So it's not like, you know, anything dangerous, but you generally want to have them on separate circuits if you can. So that's the only thing I'd say there. But most people just plug them right in and they don't have any problems with it. So anybody else have any questions? Excellent. Thank you guys for participating, man. I thought I was going to be standing up here doing this, so thank you.
Well, this is great. What is the weight limit? Not really in respect to the person operating it, but maybe you have a custom panel that weighs a little bit.
Sure.
All that combined.
So the great thing, so we're talking about the weight limit. The great thing about the weight limit is those new SFU gears that we talked about, which are pretty much coming standard in all the units, greatly enhanced the ability. Before, we didn't want to put monitors on them because monitors were heavy and everything. Now with the SFU, you can kind of get away with that. They typically say pilots up to 300 pounds, and you know, somewhere with it, like picturing a monitor and stuff, because we always had direct drive units on the racing sims. Those things can be 30, 40 pounds. So you really, unless you get crazy and try to mount like a full cockpit on this thing, you shouldn't have any problems. Now, though, I will tell you, the heavier you make it, it does impact a little responsiveness. So you don't want to just weight this thing down. But generally, it can handle, you know, unless you go crazy with it, it'll be able to handle your, you know, wing and all whatever you're doing there. Yeah, it should be fine. All right. Anybody else got any other questions? You're going to make me go back to work, aren't you? So, all right. Again, my name is Mark Shireman. I'm with DOF Reality. I really appreciate you guys taking the time. We have all kinds of things over there. So we've got plenty of pamphlets. We've got those paper airplanes that we got out here, if you're interested in those. We've got the little magnets that are the, they show the motion. And we'd just love to talk to you guys. I absolutely love this community. I'm in heaven being out here with all you guys. I love flight simming. I love being around you guys. And I just appreciate all the energy I'm getting from you guys. So thank you very much for your time. And thank you for spending some time with us here at DOF Reality. Thank you. Thanks, sir.
All right, thank you to Mark from DOF Reality. We're going to take a quick break, and at 11 o'clock, we're going to be back with Infinite Flight. All right.